like, write, subscribe, and follow me on Facebook.
If you like to make a movie request on this channel, do so in the comment section below. And feel free to check out my other shows, Modern Classics, TV Treasures, and Geek Reviews. And check out my editorials.
I'm Henry R. Mockingbird, your host with the mustache. And the review before last, I took a look at Abbott and Costello's Jack and the Beanstalk. And for this review, I'm going to take a look at their second and final Technicolor film, Abbott and Costello Meet Captain Kidd. So, let us sail the high seas as I take a look at Abbott and Costello Meet Captain Kidd. Two waiters at the tavern named Rocky and Puddinhead are given a letter from the Lady Jane to give to her lover, Bruce. But the letter ends up getting mixed up with a treasure map, and Captain Kidd and Captain Blonnie end up kidnapping them and taking them to Skull Island.
So, what do I think? Well, I'll tell you.
Well, I like it. The chemistry between Abbott and Costello is really good. And there are some good jokes and funny bits with them. Like a scene where they're trying to fill in a cannon, only for Costello to be like, screw it, and starts throwing the cannonballs. And this joke got a good laugh out of me.
We're going to Captain Kidd's quarters.
He
don't appeal to me.
Captain Kidd's. There's a scene where Puddin and Rocky go into a room, and Puddin gets soaking wet to the skin. Rocky sees him all soaking wet and all that jazz. Rocky asks, why is he so soaking wet? And he replies, it's a rub seat, and he don't get wet. And then he goes to the window again, and then he gets soaking wet again. And Rocky asks, why is he wet? And he gets ticked off at him. They find the map, and Captain Kidd just so happens to be listening. And Rocky tells Puddin to eat the map. And then he goes to a painting of Captain Kidd and draws a mustache on him with pink chalk. Then the real Captain Kidd shows up. And then Captain Kidd starts drawing a mustache on Puddinhead. After he draws the mustache, even gives him a nose, he says he enjoys that. He goes to the window, Puddinhead ducks in fear of getting wet. Then he gets wet, And then Captain Kidd opens the door, and then he gets wet. Another funny scene involves Costello serving food to Captain Kidd, and the soap gets in the soup. And then when he goes to serve Captain Kidd and Bonnie, and Captain Kidd makes weird faces while he's eating the soup, and then Captain Bonnie makes faces when she's eating the soup. Puddin' asks Captain Kidd what he thinks of the soup, and Captain Kidd replies, "Just like my mother, it stinks." Kidd tells Puddin' to eat the soup, or otherwise he'll slit his throat. And so he does eat the soup, and he starts making funny-looking faces. Looks at Captain Kidd, who gives them the stink eye, and then he looks at Bonnie, who pretty much pulls a knife. And they all decide to drink wine, and then they start blowing bubbles. Freaking bubbles! There's also a pretty funny scene in where Puddin' and Rocky start arguing and they see the injured people that Captain Kidd injured himself. Let's talk about the ruthless pirate himself, Captain Kidd, wonderfully played by Charles Laughton, which this was not the first time he played Captain Kidd, as he also played Captain Kidd in the 1945 film, simply titled Captain Kidd. Next up is Captain Bonnie, who happens to be a pirate, who happens to be a lady. And she just so happens to be played by Hilary Brooke.
I've got to follow where you go. Buttercup, I need you so. I love you.
Costello gets to kiss Hilary Brooke 3 times. That lucky bastard. Let's listen to some of the songs. First, let's listen to the theme song.
Many moons we sail beneath, the big and little dipper. And if we're loaded to the teeth, we owe it to the skipper.
We owe it to the skipper. We owe it to the skipper. Who's got a ship's from India to Madrid? Happy to have you meet
Captain Kidd.
Song is A Bachelor's Life.
Some fatherly advice. Don't throw your life away. Blow your hard-earned pay away. Son, I warn you, stay away from the shoes and rice. Girls are fun. Why pick one to be your wife? Great to be wild and free. Me for a bachelor's life. A bachelor's life. A bachelor's life.
is full of women who will marry merry men.
Some girl will make you pie eyes, sir.
Never know a dry eye, sir.
If she answers aye, aye, sir.
Life is over then. Girls are fun. Why pick one? One to be your wife. Great to be wild and free. Be for a bachelor's life. A bachelor's life.
A bachelor's life. Oh, how I love a bachelor's life.
Don't blame you.
The son of a gun. Like father, like son.
You bait your line for naught.
And it's wiser not to let any lad do what he hadn't done. If we're doomed to love in vain, then the course is very plain.
You'll have to let us cover ground out on the bounding main.
Next up is Tonight We Sail. The last and final song is Away Away I O. Had any problems with this movie is that one, Costello in this film has a weird affinity for hiding in barrels, and two is that the love interests in this movie aren't really that interesting. They're not bad, they're just not interesting. I say if you're a fan of Abbott and Costello movies or just pirate movies in general, or if you want to have a fun time, I say give this film a watch. I give it 5 gold stars. So, until the next review, I'm Henry R. Mockingbird, your host with the mustache, signing off. Gotta get back, get-